Right now, we're outside the famous Naieb restaurant. This is the headquarters and the oldest restaurant out of the six that they have across Iran. Today, it's its 50th anniversary, but the actual taste started over 130 years ago. And here we have the great-great-granddaughter of Mr. Naieb himself to show us around of why this kebab just tastes so amazing.
همونجور که اولم گفتم این عکس پدر بزرگ خود من هستش که ایشون پدرشون هستن و اصل نایب اصلا از پدر ایشون همین علی آقای نایب به وجود اومده در سال 1254.
Naieb is one of the most popular restaurants, but it's mainly through reservation, targeting the middle class to the upper class. Although it actually started its business in the bazaars, alongside many of the other very famous kebabi restaurants.
مهمه برامون که شکل کبابام به همین شکل.
The kebabs are being dipped in the juice of the onions. I guess that's their secret to their amazing tasting kebabs.
Basically, they're putting all the different types of kebabs that they make and cook all in a line. So you've got the fillet, and then you've got the chicken, and then you've got the famous kubideh. So the meat and fat is then grinded, and with other either onions and other spices, exactly. Then it's made into the kubideh. I've tried to make kubideh so many times, but it keeps falling off the skewer. So when there's more fire, it actually keeps the juice inside.
Exactly. But not that the roast is soft, huh?
And then
the first thing that we put is from the place where the fire was given.
So this is the bag, and this is the kubideh. I'm really excited. She was just explaining that, you know, a lot of people, like, some of the traditional ways of eating kebab is by putting a raw egg on top of the rice. And we have this dried, I mean, there's this powder, it's called somok, which is very sour. And you put it on top of the kebab, so you just kind of like place it like this. But it's got this really nice sour taste to it. And then also a raw egg right in the middle. So you mix the raw egg with the butter and the rice, and then you put the kebabs on top and eat away. Oh. It's very good. It's nice and juicy. I mean, it just like melts in your mouth and you're complete. You're just taken over by the taste of good meat. It's funny because actually the tea is sort of as important as the food, because the tea culture is just a whole other world in itself, you know? It's a way of bringing in a guest.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. سفرخونه باغ سبا در یکی از محله‌های قدیمی تهران به نام باغ سبا. خدمت عرض کنم که سفرخونه ما یکی از گفتم از مجموعه‌های کارهای هنری و معماری درست شده. اینجا نه که سفرخونه سنتیه و اگه یکی از فرهنگ‌های اصیل ایرانی رو داریم باغ می‌کنیم و نشون می‌دیم نه به نمایش درگیریم.
But back in the days, the tea houses were mainly for men. Today, they have been transformed into family venues.
Places like this are usually symmetrical and people sit around in circles. And it just creates this environment where
you know, everyone's interacting with each other. You've got the music in the center, and then you got people sitting here, you've got others walking around. And if you see the paintings, this is the environment where people told old stories, they talked about poetry, they smoked the shisha, or the qalyun, as some call it.
اینی که شما این پدیده ایری که میبینید شربت زعفرونه.
شربت زعفرون. زعفران تی.
زعفران تی. ببینید نکنید این از توی زعفران قاطی شده و خونک هم هست. و این یک خاصیت پزشکی داره.
آه خیلی ممنون. پس اول شربت رو خورده میشه بعد شایی.
بعد میریم سراغ چایی. سرویس چای گرد.
Here he was explaining the different sweets that are served with the tea. This we have the crystallized sugar, the famous dates, and this is bamiye, which comes from Zulbia bamiye. The two different types of sweets that are made, the wheat is fried, and then there's syrup poured on top. And then this is his own signature, because it comes from his hometown, which is Hamedan. And it's not too sweet, so you can easily have many of them one after another.
اینا غذای
گرمتونه.
بله. The hot foods. این به ترتیب نکنید. این کوفته ریزه ماست.
میشه یکی امتحان. این اصلیتش از کجاست؟ کوفته.
این مال تبریز.
آه مال تبریز. مرسی. I love کوفته. So now you see the mother of kuftes. So this is they have as the main dish. And it's quite a hearty meal. Here you have the two famous eggplant dishes, which is Kashka Bademjoon and Mirza Qasemi. Mirza Qasemi is tomatoes, eggplants with a good amount of garlic. And then Kashka Bademjoon is the same with, it's just eggplant with lentils and meat. And then they put this whey sauce on top. And then if you're still not full, there is dolmeh. And dolmeh is a mixture of rice and meat and lentils. I actually split peas, to be exact, with a very specific type of herb that they mix it. And they stuff them in eggplants, tomatoes, and peppers. And of course, there's the very famous barley soup. This is just to start you off. You know, just to tease you a little for the main dish. In case you weren't full after the salads and the teas and the fruits. We're right now at a fish farm, and here they harvest caviar.
یک بزرگتر ماهیامونه. 12 سالشه.
Oh, that's one. It's like a burger.